played on Dreamland a ton.
Oh,
so there
final
you.
D.
Okay, they're going to FD. They're going to get a neutral start here. Okay, so Dext3r is normal Pika. Mariguas is light Pika. We've got Tacos going Pika. So Tacos has been the story of doubles so far.
Yeah, he's been going Pika instead of Kirby.
No, he's been going Kirby.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he's been going Kirby, and he absolutely killed it in winners finals and winners semis. Like, easily the best player out here.
Right. I wonder what made him switch.
Maybe going to the alternate stages did. So Kirby would have been a bad choice on this stage, actually.
Oh,
wow.
The
zip zaps. So team composition doesn't matter, just like in the last game, if it's all the same team and you're going to a certain stage. Okay, ceiling a little higher here.
Yeah, that's
as well as the sides are
see,
also.
See, that's why
higher,
I thought
lighter.
You would like to have a Kirby here because I mean he can still kill, but the blast zones are maybe to help recover.
The problem is so edge guarding is a lot easier on the stage, especially in doubles, because you cover ledge and then you just grab when they get on stage. There's
right,
no ledge shenanigans.
That makes Pika's recovery easier too.
Yes, I know, yeah. but the thing is Kirby is really exposed recovering here, and what's worse is that Kirby's slow. Part of what makes Tacos so great in doubles is he makes Kirby look fast.
Right.
And he's able to do that by using clever platform movement.
That's
if
right.
you don't have the platforms, his run speed is just so slow. He'd have a hard time helping the Z out.
Yeah, Kirby is a lot weaker without platform movement.
Wow.
Oh, and the up tilt to down,
oh
he still
my
doesn't
God.
Kill.
Still doesn't kill. Enormous blast zones. Oh, and we have an SD from Tacos, who's third player. Tacos being ghost peek on blue
I'm
team.
Used to seeing Dext3r and Mariguas go blue in teams, I thought.
Yeah, but they've been going green and losers. I don't know. I think someone else went blue and they just
stuck with it. But
haven't gotten off the setup. So.
Yeah, the lack of platforms, it definitely makes Kirby a lot more difficult to use.
So I don't know if they decided that before or after they started playing, but okay, so this should be easy edge guards. Grab. And then, oh, there's two of them, though, and couldn't decide on a target.
It's a lot harder to go up against this double Pika team when you don't have those quick kill confirms, like a back to throw to down air that a Samus or a Kirby might have. And, yes, you're giving yourself a lot more recoverability, but you're losing that kill power.
The Z is actually, unless... They're wrong again, which they aren't. The Z is actually the one hanging onto the stocks this time as the Pika. What we saw in Winners was when they were Pika Kirby, the Z actually, he had some SDs, but he was also in the fray. He's just willing to lose stocks because Tacos was hanging onto them.
Right.
That's not what we're seeing here. I don't know if that's a result of the team comp or a difference in play from Tacos or the Z.
Kirby can be surprisingly tanky.
Absolutely.
A lot of times dark. When we're doing
there
stock
you go.
Thing.
Beautiful. So... Again, easy edge guard with two people on the stage. One person just grabs ledge, no shenanigans, up smash to down B.
Right. It's like the lack
of
platforms.
The, game.
The lack of platforms completely it makes the recovery game like one dimensional basically.
This is really close. If they can get Tacos' stock, it's an even game. If he hangs onto it for a while, which we've seen in Winners. Okay, there he goes. But they go grab. Yeah, it's the grab train. It's almost the same thing as Puff's Rest, honestly. One person gets a grab, and it's just start trading.
Chain reaction.
Good spacing out from Tacos and the Z. Oh, nice jab grab from Tacos to get Dext3r off stage. Both are off stage. This is rough. The Z with a nice read on that down air. Mariguas makes it back. So does Dext3r's back. Can he help Mariguas recover? Oh, Mariguas
Blue team
is done.
Has just been dismantling them this last stock. They've just been
all
over them, completely outspacing them at every turn.
And the important thing is they got him off stage, but it was still early percents. They just did not let up.
Right.
They said, no way are you getting back to a neutral position from here.
It looked like Green was playing super aggressive, and any time they tried to jump up at the Blue team, Blue was ready for it with a strong punish. Perfect spacing. We'll see how a different stage might affect this, because I don't think we'll be going back to FD for game two. Do we have...
So the question is, what are we going to see?
They can't go back to the stage that they won on.
It's a counterpick for the losers.
Yeah, I'm saying later on.
No, yeah. So later on, Tacos and the Z can't go back to the last stage they won.
Okay.
Yeah, so if Tacos and the Z wins... Yeah, Dave's stupid rule.
Yeah.
If Tacos and the Z win another game on, like, Battlefield, then they could go back to FD.
Okay.
Unless you do modified DSR, which wasn't specified, but whatever.
Okay, I don't remember what was in the rule book.
It basically doesn't say.
Okay. I try and suggest all these things, but... Oh, okay. So I guess Narwhal be Lodo.
Nice.
So...
Yeah, just Narwhal. It's just for grand, and then he'll be.
Wow.
He's just for grand.
Yeah,
just free. So yeah,
good work. Cool. Good work.
All right, so we're going back.
Right back to it.
Not what I expected at all. I mean, so Yoshi's is a little bit of a. Yoshi's and Kongo are both like risks, and if they thought that they're not going to win on.
You see this aerial game that Tacos and Z are playing.
They're great.
They're winning against. Mexico every time. They just pull them up into the air and they're jumping at them every time. And Blue's just ready for it.
So, yeah, we're seeing especially Team Love has had...
Oh my god.
Wow. Team Love has had the advantage, especially when they're next to each other. So there's a few different positioning things that can happen, especially on FD. You can either have two teams on either side working with each other against each other. You can have a sandwich situation, or you can have alternating. When blue team has been on the same side as each other in sort of neutral, so to speak, they've just had the overwhelming advantage. I think their team chemistry just comes through in their ability to wall out Team Mexico.
Sweet sledge snap from
that
Mexico.
Edge, yeah.
So when without the platforms to, you know, give a second level to the neutral game, Blue is just using their double jumps and just going way up. And
you know,
for some reason, Green's just chasing them every time.
You know what Team Mexico might have been thinking? Maybe they didn't want to play against the Kirby.
True. Maybe they thought that
Tacos was going to switch to Kirby if they went to a three-platform stage, and they didn't want that, then...
I wouldn't want that.
If anyone saw Tacos play, they know that he's just been...
And,
oh, wow.
That lack of chemistry you're talking about, just hitting your own teammate.
Team Love has no chemistry, obviously. Okay, on stage... Wow, there... Oh, wow. Gets out of hit stun just before... Nice snare to finish it off. Okay, Mexico's winning.
Oh no.
Okay. Wow.
Uncharacteristic to see Team Love dropping a combo.
Wow, but they still pick it up. Again, nowhere to run on FT. There's just one stage, one platform.
You see the utilizing the invincibility to get a double bear on.
Where are you supposed to go in invincibility in this stage?
Yeah.
There's nowhere to run. You can't even trick them with platforms. You just.
Oh wow.
Beautiful down smash from Mariguas. Okay, they're both covering the same spot. I don't like that.
That nair was not really helpful.
Beautiful decision by Tacos to just recover extremely high and just say, like, look, you're either going to get, like, a weak nair or something, or my teammate's going to come back and save me.
It's back air.
Oh, wow, nice. Nice trade.
Oh, and the dash attack into... Yeah, up air is all he could really reach with, but that's going to give him a chance to recover.
Okay. Was that
unfortunate
a team? Yeah. Man, Team Love, actually, they do have crazy chemistry, but so far in both winners and losers, they've
been hitting each other
killed
a lot.
Not a lot, but like the one game that Tacos and Z lost to South America, Tacos killed Z twice.
Wow.
Yeah, so they're all about it, right? They're live or die by the team combo.
Ooh. And the jab's going to set him up in an edge guard situation. Nowhere to run, but good job from the teammate giving him some space, keeping him in the center stage. See if it's hard to commentate.
Yeah, no, of course. It always is in dubs, but... Yeah, Team Love actually at the disadvantage here. Mexico made the adjustments. Actually, I don't even know... Oh, wow, nice. I don't even know how many adjustments they made so much as just played a little bit cleaner. This is pretty convincing. Oh wow!
Faded pretty hard down there, but you know they're going for the quick kill.
Yeah, they're trying to be done with this game.
surprised that neutral B didn't.
Here's a question. Where do Dext3r, where do Tacos and the Z go?
Oh,
and
anywhere
what do Dext3r and Mariguas ban? Do you think they're still going to ban Dreamland, or do you think they're going to say, dang, dude, like, all of them have three platforms? Well, Congo doesn't.
I think they'll
Dext3r and Mariguas, I think if they're going to get a if they're able to get a counterpick after this next game, like, say Tacos and the Z win the next game,
right.
I think the counterpick for Dext3r and Mariguas that they have to keep is Congo. I think that's if they're trying to avoid the Kirby, that's the stage.
Perhaps, yeah.
But Tacos and the Z kind of have their pick here. Dext3r and Mariguas could ban Dreamland, but you still have what am I trying to say? You still have Battlefield, which
right.
is similar in a lot of ways. It's different. Oh my god! Please no.
Where could they be going with the Falcon? I don't think that's a thing.
No, they're just. He's just hitting B and A, and it takes you to the right. Yeah, that's what I wanted to hear. I like Jigglypuff.
Jiggle, 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 jiggle.
Oh, they're waiting on the ban.
Okay. Alright, so they're staying.
Yeah, they banned Dreamland.
Yeah, of course. And despite the additional
and
platforms,
yep.
they're
no Kirby.
Yeah, no Kirby.
I disagree with that decision.
I disagree. Yeah, it's
I'm not supposed to it's one of my own rules is I'm not supposed to be giving advice to the players who are on stream, but
right.
I just saw Tacos' Kirby was so damn good
right.
earlier. Like, I can't believe that they're deciding not to do it. Maybe they just think that Mariguas and Dext3r are going to be really good against Kirby. Maybe we're reading the politics here totally wrong. I don't know.
I can't say, like, switching
wow,
off your
okay.
main is always a very dangerous decision. But
wow, okay, so three early stocks already gone.
Four.
Well, that's... Dext3r and Mariguas did that twice now. I do yeah. not see them coming back to Battlefield in the near future.
Yeah.
Okay, great job of Dext3r to get in there.
Oh,
Dext3r's
that ledge cancel was so slick.
Dext3r's been playing an amazing support role as Pikachu thus far. Pass. Nair. Will not kill. The blast zones on this stage are almost identical to Dreamland in both height and width.
See, that's interesting because when we were playing earlier against Clubba and Revan, we were all commenting on how much bigger it felt.
Well, the reason it feels bigger is the stage is smaller. The stage is much thinner, and actually it's taller as well. So because of that, there's way more open space on the sides of the map.
Okay.
Throwing from the side of the stage is not nearly the same as throwing from the side of Dreamland.
Right.
But from the center, it's actually pretty close. So, this is definitely a very fast-paced match on this stage. Everyone's really close to each other.
Interesting. Yeah.
Dext3r and Mariguas trailing here by some percent on a stock. Oh wow. But this is Tacos we're talking about. Tacos hanging on to the stock is really keeping them in this game. Wow.
A good save. Oh, that should be a stock right there.
Yeah,
two teams got stage control.
Tacos is this stock for Tacos is the backbreaker and has been the backbreaker all tournament.
What a recovery.
Wow.
I like the single zip and with the fade back, and then his teammate was there to
wow.
cover the ledge.
Z trying to get something started. Wow, Tacos still living.
Yeah, they're doing such a good job of preserving each other's stocks.
The absolute backbreaker from Tacos. My goodness. Seriously, like every team has gone down to Tacos
wow.
just hanging on to stocks.
And they're really making Pico look easy to edge guard. They're just four or five series of hits in a row, racking up a ton of damage. See if they can.
This is pretty tough for Team Mexico, but they are going to be able to get a counter pick here to bring it to in game four. Still not out of it yet. Oh, caught under stage. The Z off stage. Oh man.
And he covers ledge. I was going to say an up smash would have done it there.
Yeah.
Focusing too much on both players. If they can just get one, it's a much easier situation.
Okay, good. Good of them not to both go for that, because that would have been bad. Ooh.
Still living.
Okay. Mariguas gets a kill. If they're able to bring it to last.
Oh, he jumped right into a grab, but
that's
he got
fine.
Thrown.
Oh, forward throw will finally kill. Oh, that's it. Not quite, but might as well be. What's the counter pick? First off, what's the ban?
At this point,
they could ban Congo.
Yeah. I'm
not a mind reader. I don't actually know if Mexico would want to go to Congo, but Team Love could ban Congo and then basically force a 3. Oh, I would bet Mariguas and Dext3r. If Congo is banned, I would bet they're going to Yoshi's and vice versa.
Right.
Or maybe they're just done with it and they're going to go Dreamland. I don't know. But Yoshi's is a super high variant stage. Oh, are we going to see the switch?
Yes. Oh boy.
Okay, so what was the stage pick?
I don't know.
Mexico opts to go battlefield again. Wow. Literally what I said at the start of the match.
They've lost twice, and their counter pick both times has been the stage that they lost on.
Which is actually not, like, it's not the worst in the world, because if you can just get that win back, then you still have, like...
They're believing in their momentum more than their ability to
mix up the stage. If you manage to win it, it's kind of nice, because then you, you basically remove the fact that the counterpicking is an advantage.
Right.
You're like, oh yeah, I'm just going to win on the counterpick, though. It's not a problem.
And it's really crazy to see a team only pick the stage that they've lost on. We'll see how far this goes into the grand finals.
Well, we also saw Tacos think for a minute about going Kirby depending on the stage, right? So
that read
is definitely still alive.
It's getting in their head.
Team Mexico off to a really good start here again in that forward throw will not kill. That down B will not kill either.
Oh, bad angle.
Little bit taller on this stage. I don't know if that played into it.
Yeah, that's a tough angle from Z.
Ooh. Tacos, don't do this again, man. If he hangs onto this stock again, he just, oh my goodness.
So good.
Okay, Mariguas, after a slight blunder, still gets the kill on Tacos. That's huge. They're now up 2 very clean stocks here. If they can get to some good percents.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Mexico's doing a good job of separating the two of them.
The X factor a lot of times here, what we've seen is the Team Love combos. If they can get a team combo going, it really, your zero to death ability, even against Pikas, is way better. Oh, wow. But as I say that, Team Mexico goes on their own combo.
Ooh, floating in the air there. Let's see. Oh, he had an up smash right there at the top platform. Didn't go for it.
I think he was worried about the shield. Mariguas still with the stock here, gets the back throw. He's going in. Yeah, so we've seen when Mariguas is at high percent, he's trying to get the percent. He's not trying to camp it out. He's not trying to hang on to the stock. He's trying to get his bang for his buck. Interesting interaction there. Great for Mariguas to run in there. Forward throw. Runs into the hurt box. Good grab from Tacos. Oh, wow. Great nair from Dext3r. The target switching is impeccable from both teams.
It's interesting. Earlier, they were opting to try and edgeguard both players, but now it seems like they've changed. Team Green has changed their approach to zooming in on one player, letting the other recover.
Honestly, Dext3r is playing... Dext3r just got wrecked, but he's been playing like a monster this game. If you watch him in his one-on-one interactions, he's just absolutely schooling the Z and Tacos. And Mariguas is somehow, he's finding so many kills.
What a hard read on that recovery with the back air.
Still able to get him. Okay, but able to get there for Mariguas to recover. Nice back air from Dext3r. And that will do it for one, but not for the Z.
I think the real difference maker this game is the teamwork from Team Green.
Team Mexico is doing amazing, yeah.
Yeah, 2v1-ing and saving each other from 2v1 situations.
The question is, if they need one game to adapt to every stage,
are they
done for game 5? Is it over already? Okay, so a 1-stock lead, now a 2-stock lead, but close to a 1-stock lead for Team Mexico. Oh, wow. Okay, Tacos able to get back. Low enough percent.
They just need to take one off of Mariguas and put a little pressure on them. As long as the damage is
adding up.
Yeah. So as long as Mariguas is holding on to that stock, they're not really going anywhere with this game.
Yeah, if they could somehow kill Dext3r here real early, but that is not it for Tacos. My gosh.
Oh,
that won't be it either. It'll kill. Oh, wow.
Oh, whoa.
Just
barely.
Tacos. Messing up, almost making it anyway. Someone grab ledge, please.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
That's it. Wow.
Game five?
Wow. Okay, so what's the ban?
Yeah, where do they go now?
Okay, well, but here's the thing that Dext3r and Mariguas did wrong. Tacos and the Z, Dave's stupid rule isn't even in effect.
Right. We need a new name for that, too. We really do. That's embarrassing.
Just call it DSR, but yeah.
It's embarrassing.
So
far they played on only two stages.
So there will be one ban. They can go... I don't know. I don't know how... If we're doing modified or not, if we can go to... if we can go back to FD. But...
Yeah, I don't know if anyone would argue about it at this point. Because they're all picking stages that they've, you know, lost on anyway. So I don't think Mexico has any qualms with playing right into...
I'm trying to listen to the debate here. Oh, are we going to see Kirby?
Oh, we might.
Oh, they're speaking Spanish, but... Oh, they banned Congo.
Okay. Yeah, not surprising.
My read was super wrong. Oh, okay, switch to Kirby, Dreamland. Yep. Yeah. Okay, so this is what Mariguas and Dext3r have been avoiding for literally three sets now. And we'll see if this will pay off or not. Reminder that if Dext3r and Mariguas win this, there's still another set for Team Love. They're not done yet. So if we see Team Mexico win this, we might see a lot more Dreamland. But we'll see if Tacos' Kirby is anything like it was in Winners or in Winners Finals and Semis. This could be tough.
Yeah, it doesn't seem like.
But you know, maybe they didn't play Dext3r and Mariguas before, so maybe Dext3r and Mariguas are going to be really good against the Kirby. We'll see. The Z. Oh wow, nice zip zap out. I thought he was going to get grabbed. Wow, Tacos.
Good lead snap, yeah.
Amazing recovery, but that'll be it for his stock. So already Tacos losing a stock. That hasn't been the MO for this team and could spell...
Doom.
Could spell... Well, bad news at least, you know? We're not going to talk Doom. It's not Doom, actually, because they still have losers. It could spell trouble.
I don't see Team Love playing as vertically patient as they were when they won at least their first game.
I think the credit there goes to Team Mexico. Dext3r and
making sure that doesn't work for them.
Dext3r in particular, his movement has been incredible in the last two games. Really just being able to work himself around the stage to be both helpful and threatening. Mariguas, just a juggernaut though, as usual.
Well, Tacos, I don't know if that necessarily helped.
It was okay. Yeah. Sometimes stray hits hit your teammate and it's all right, but...
Oh!
Wow, jumps right into it. I don't think Mariguas was expecting Dext3r to just pull that out rando.
There's a thunder.
Hits his teammate.
See if they can. There's everyone's at high percent, right?
Right.
We need to get some grabs here. I've seen several. Back-
oh wow! There goes the Z. Tacos, patient as ever though, and actually gets the kill on Mariguas. Dext3r not quite dead. Tacos opts to just play it safe, go over by his teammate. They know they'll get Dext3r eventually. And backing up this damage on Mariguas.
Great team combo.
Wow. So Dext3r hangs onto the stock, but the risk inherent of hanging onto that stock, if you're not aggressive enough, is you leave your teammate on an island, and that's exactly what happened to Mariguas there. There's the F smash. It's.
Well, they.
They do not.
Oh, they do not have a lead.
Yeah, no, because that it was when they were able to take the stock with the team combo
on Mariguas
that it just changed the pace of the whole game.
And this Kirby is really making a big difference for them. The team combos seem a lot easier for team love when they have their characters.
Yeah, I mean, this might go to show that, Mexico is right in trying to avoid Dreamland and the Kirby, but...
I mean, it's not that far off, really. It's a fairly close match, but I think that's been a big difference.
If they're going to make... Oh, well, Z dies. If they're going to make the difference here, they're going to have to just eliminate those stocks from Tacos. You can get team combos on Kirby. He's pretty edge guardable. They've got to get something started on Tacos or if they're going to have a hope here.
But the team, both teams are, well, Team Love is two grabs away from getting a 2v1. And
but
that would be great.
The Z, Tacos loses his stock. The Z all alone, only at 57%.
And
but
we got
team Mexico actually with the lead now. Okay.
Oh, you can't grab. Can't grab like that.
Yeah, that grab, that's an immediate trade. So if Team Mexico loses the stock from Mariguas, oh, wow. Team combo on Dext3r, then this
just absolutely brutal devastation from Team Love.
Could that be the set winner?
And
oh my goodness!
But we have high percent from the Z. But
wow!
Tacos
closes
it out. That
Tacos,
team combo,
Tacos MVP of doubles, absolutely obliterated it. Anytime you went Kirby,
that last team combo was such.